Greetings. I have returned once again with another Metroid Samus Aran figure review. So, in this figure review, I'm going to be reviewing the Other World Nintendo Samus Aran 4-inch action figure. So here she is right here. Now, I didn't take her out of the box yet because I wanted to save it, the unboxing, just for this video. It's special today because today is the Metroid Celebration's final day, so it'll be extra special for the Samus figure. Alright, and for you, as a viewer. Okay, so here's the box. It's kind of like a back carding cardboard style box with like the small figure in the front underneath the plastic shell or case, which is kind of cool. I like that style. It just really makes it hard to open, you know what I'm saying? Because I've been wanting to open this thing forever just to touch it and play with it and to figure out like what's inside this mystery box. Okay, because I'm like dying to play with this figure, but I didn't want to open it because I thought, oh, it's going to be worth more one day. But I'm like, well, I can just buy another one and then open this one and buy a brand new one and leave it in the box for display. Anyways, so I must say that there's a lot of color going on in this carding. I love the teal color right up here. It's like the Metroid toys are themed, like the color theme is teal color, which is pretty cool. My Metroid toy that I just did a review on like an hour ago is the same color as this, so that's cool, they have matching colors. I love this right here. I love that they actually printed her from Metroid Prime 3 Corruption style Samus on the box. I love that. That right there makes me feel bad for opening this. Just that, let alone. But anyway, I'm going to open it for you guys. Especially for you. So, she's right in here. She's kind of doing a weird pose like this. It's kind of awkward. But right here it says Samus Mystery Accessory. There's the box right here. You can kind of hear it rolling around there. I already know what's inside. Just, I'll keep it a surprise for you guys. So yeah, that's cool. I like how they have her right in front. She's stuck in there pretty well. If you can see, there's the front, World Nintendo. This is, this Samus figure along with the Metroid is Wave 2. Like, Wave Series 1 through 2, but this is 2. On the back, there's a lot going on. There's Samus Aran right there. Nintendo seal, World Nintendo. Right here, you can see Samus, now, I haven't taken her out of the box yet, I know, but I can already tell that this style of Samus right here, that must have been, like, a prototype or something, because the figure in the box does not look like the one on the back. I mean, you guys are seeing this, right? It looks way different. She's doing a different pose, her style of armor is different, it just looks like they went for an Other M prototype, slash original, like, Super Metroid or something. I'm not sure, it's kind of weird. We'll get into that when I take out the figure, though. So right here, it says, 4.5-inch figure. So it's like 4.5 inches tall with 14 points of articulation, so that's a lot. Collect them all. Right down here, you can see more Series 2, or Wave 2, World Nintendo toys, Diddy Kong, Bluto, Luigi, Ganondorf, and the Metroid, which I already have. I used to have Ganon, but I sold him, like I said in my last video. So yeah, the back of my box, when I first ordered this, I think I won it off eBay for about 20, which, these actually only go for, like, $8 at least, or $10 to $8, or $8 to $10. So, when you buy these, I kind of got a little ripped off, but I was so anxious to get one, I didn't care, because they weren't in stores yet. So I thought, I'm never going to find it anyway, because for some reason, Samus is never on the shelf. So yeah, when I first got this, I thought the person opened it in the back, because it looks like it's taped right there, so I'm like, did they just open this, play with it, and put it back or something? I don't know if I like that it looks used, but they're all supposed to be taped, just to be sure to give it some extra backing. But yeah, it's okay. I mean, like, I'm gonna open it in a minute. I'll just cut down the tape. I just don't want to tear up my box, you know what I'm saying? So yeah, there's the back. Underneath, you can see the Metroid Prime 3 Corruption. Oops. Logo right here, which is cool. I like that they actually added the Corruption logo. It's pretty sweet. Jakks specific logos and, you know, basically copyright stuff. So yeah, this is a collectible figure. Definitely get it if you're more into, like, the cheaper stuff and you just don't have enough money to afford expensive figures, like, you know, the $100 ones or more. Definitely get this one, because this is pretty much perfect for you if you're, like, on a budget. But yeah, you're supposed to be able to find these things in Toys R Us and Target. I've had no luck. just like with my Metroid figure I just did a review on, I've had no luck with this toy. I cannot find it anywhere except for online, and everybody's raising the prices on it. So it's really hard to get one underneath $10 without it being bid up like, you know, like crazy. That's how I got mine for 20. That's okay, at least I didn't pay like 50 or something. I waited. So yeah. Let's just take in this beautiful box. I'm just gonna miss its boxy goodness because I'm gonna open it right now. Alright, so here we go. Got an X-Acto, be careful. Alright, so here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna take the X-Acto and I'm gonna cut down the side, I'm gonna cut the tape. Now I'm gonna try to take my X-Acto along this edge of the plastic casing. Alright, so here we go. I'm gonna try to be gentle because I don't want to hurt my box. Alright. This may take some time. Alright. We got that edge off. Alright. Time to do the one at the bottom. There's it storming out there. Getting a little nervous. Oh, jeez. Cut away from yourself. Don't cut towards yourself, I know. Alright. As you can see, inevitably there's going to be some carding ripped off, which is, at least Samus is back there. Just the normal Mario toy, so yeah. There's a flap right here. You can see that, a flap down here. Oh, there's some in the front too, great. I just forgot about that. Great. I'm trying to figure out a safe point to enter. Right here. Sorry, I just really don't want to hurt myself or the toy. Yeah, just take your fingers and lift it up. Alright. Just dragging my fingers along the carding. Alright, so here we have it. Jeez. Alright, so here's the back. The box came off. Hopefully I did that right. I can always, like, re-glue it or something. Alright. Let's take her out of the shell casing. Gosh, I've been dying to do this. Alright. Take out the mystery box. Hold on. Now keep in mind, because I'm a collector, this is painful for me to do. Alright, so here's a mystery box. It's like a little black cardboard box. Really light, thin, paperboard or something. Has the Metroid symbol on the front. All over, basically. Looks like a Super Metroid symbol, so that's pretty neat. Actually, I'll just open it right now. So inside the mystery box is, I already know, Samus Aran's Morph Ball! Woohoo! Isn't that awesome? Cute little Morph Ball. It's cute. I like the green center, the orange color, and then like the red all around it. That's pretty neat. I love that. Probably easy to lose though, so be careful. I'd recommend leaving it in your mystery box. So I'm about to put it back. There we go. Cool. Alright. So, this is Samus. Pretty much, she's pretty stuck in there at the case. I'm gonna get my scissors and cut her out. It's like this little clear band. That was easy. Alright. So now, she's gonna be stuck in there, I can tell. Come on, Samus. You can do it. There we go. She's out of the shell. She's pretty much lodged in there. Alright, so here she is. Oh, this is so cool. I've been wanting to touch this and play this forever. Alright, so this is Samus herself. She's 4.5 inches tall, which means she's 4.5. For a very small toy, little action figure, this is, got pretty good details and articulation. I mean, she can't really do what they have on the box, which is why I was a little confused, because the picture on the back, right here, it shows something totally different. Now, I'm sure I'm not the only one that can tell or can see that, but it's totally, this is not the Metroid Prime 3 corruption style. This is a prototype or something. It's kind of false advertising. You think you're going to get that, but you don't. She cannot, I don't think she can do that pose, as a matter of fact. But yeah, here she is. She can, like, bend her legs. Pretty much like that. I know that in a picture I saw of her, she was, like, running and doing this, and it looked kind of dorky. She can't even put her arm over her gun. She can't do much. It's a little disappointing in her articulation. But, I mean, I'm not disappointed with this toy. I love anything. I was really, really excited for this toy. It's actually a lot softer than I thought it'd feel. It's sort of like a soft plastic. Like a little squishy. You can turn her head. Like that. You can do this, basically. Bring her shoulders close. Oh, you can do this. She's aiming. The inside of her gun is orangish yellow, like it's lighting up, so that's cool. You can't move really. You can like spin her feet around, but you can't really move them. Like this does not have as good articulation as the other M Figma, of course. And it's not as big as the Joyride figure. This is kind of small. I prefer bigger figures. As a matter of fact, I heard they're making a 6-inch Samus soon, so that'd be awesome. So yeah. Her arm cannon is kind of like a minty green color. I can see her lights in there. That's cool. If you can see the yellow. You can see her lights in her arm cannon that go back and forth. But yeah, this is really neat. It's a little small for my liking, but I mean, I'm glad I bought it because I have to get every single figure. I'm just really excited that I finally lived in an age where I could buy a Samus figure in the box, like brand new. Not anymore. I'll probably be regretting that later, but you know what? I can always get another one when I get rich or something because I'm kind of broke. But yeah, you can move her torso back and forth. She can spin around like that if you want to make her like go this way or something and do that. She can move every joint. You could put her shoulder up like that. It's kind of cool. Move her legs. Looks kind of weird. I like to make her look like she's like jumping to the air or something. Yeah, this is neat. So yeah, I mean, I wouldn't pay like 50 or more. Like, just I wouldn't pay over 20 for these. They're not worth it, to be honest. They're small. I'm not saying I'm disappointed. I'm happy I have this. I'm so glad I finally get to open it because I can play with it. This would probably be more like a play figure for me than a collectible. No, I wish I wouldn't have opened the box still, but I can tape it shut again. Thank God. And it was already taped before, so wouldn't be much better or much worse. One thing I'll say about this figure is that there kind of some color mess ups, like some spots they forgot to paint, or, you know, it's not perfect. They forgot to put her green lights in the shoulders. You can see it's just black. They could have just put a speck of paint or something. It's a really cute figure, though. I like the chest part and torso the best. I like how it's shaped. They did a good job making that. It just looks like a miniature from Corruption. I mean, they did a good job making it. I just wish it was bigger. I can't wait for more figures from Jakks Pacific and World Nintendo. That's their line that this was made from. Also, I wish they'd give us, like, something to shoot, like a beam or something. That'd be kind of cool. Kind of like the other M Figma. But hey, we got, like, the awesome Morph Ball to go with this. So that's cool. I'll take it out again. Come on. There we go. Wants to roll around on me. There we go. It's, a little bit smaller than what her actual body is. I know people always wonder, how does she get a Morph Ball? She's so big. Well, alien magic, okay? That's all I can say. She can roll through ball by alien magic. It can roll. That's cool. Yeah, this is pretty neat. I really do like the paint on it, the colors, the neon green. I also wish that they incorporate, like, some, when she rolls, the light lights up behind it. That'd be kind of a cool toy. Like, they made a remote control toy that you could, like, control her morph ball with or something, and it'd light up. That'd be so awesome. Cool toy idea. Sorry, my screen went dark. So yeah, I recommend getting this figure if you want a cheap toy to play with. If you don't really care about opening a box, I always do anyway, but it's cheap. Look around Target and Toys R Us. I haven't been able to find it there. It pisses me off because I just all I see is Mario, Yoshi's, and Donkey Kong. That's all I can see. Sometimes Legend of Zelda, but Metroid, like I said before, I think it has something to do with it being rated teen for teen. And Zelda and Mario are rated E for everyone, so it's safer for it's more kid friendly. Metroid's creepy, like I was saying, and it's hard to play. But yeah, I definitely recommend getting this figure if you want a cheap one. Don't, like I said, don't pay over 20 for these. You can get them on eBay, toy stores. I got mine from eBay. I didn't want to pay over 15, but I won the bid at 20, so yeah. Definitely get it. This is gonna be my new play toy. I mean, you can still use it for display. I plan on buying a new one just so I can have a box, but then this is my first one, so you know, it's special to me. So yeah, there's the box. Just keep everything. The Morph Ball's cute. So yeah, I hope you like this figure as much as I do. I hope you could, you know, purchase it if you love Metroid, you want something to play with. This one I'd be more, you know, I'd let a kid play with it more than I would my other ones, because this one's just, it's tiny, it's meant to be played with. I think the age limit was like 3 years and up or something. So yeah, I recommend getting it. I hope you enjoy this figure review. I'll see you next mission.